Welcome back to this week's episode of Alchemy. We have a very special holiday episode coming out. I'm pumped to welcome the legendary Ric Flair, Nature Boy on Alchemy. Ric, thanks for coming on, man.
Thank you. Thanks for having me. Happy holiday.
Happy holidays. So, you know, for everybody that is that's tuning in now, I mean, Ric, everybody knows you. You know, you're the greatest professional wrestler of all time. You're an icon. You've had, what, 16 world championship titles. You've won two times the WWE Hall of Famer Award. And you're one of the most prolific superstars in pro wrestling history. So I'm excited to have you on the show. But Ric, why don't we, I think it'd be a great time to like kick off. We have an amazing documentary coming out on the Peacock Network right after Christmas on the 26th. Talk to us about it.
Well, it's the most accurate depiction of my life, actually in its entirety, that's ever been put together, because I got sick right after we filmed the ESPN documentary. And I really, the first time I was ever even out of the house was the day I saw it. And then I didn't remember seeing it. That's how bad I was back then.
You were literally, I mean, you were basically going to die.
Yeah. And it debuted, I got out of the hospital at the end of October. And the first time I'd ever even been out of the house, they took me to the premiere in Atlanta downtown. Mm-hmm. And I was so blown back by it, but I really didn't get all my memory back until February of 18.
Wow.
So I didn't remember what I saw.
Crazy.
Yeah.
That's okay. Well, listen, we're happy you're here.
Yeah, me too.
And so Ric, you know, I think, you know, for one, let's go ahead and let's roll the preview. Let's let people see it.
Okay.
Ric Flair was never a character. It's been my life. The good and the bad. Fair to say, I'm a complicated man.
He was ahead of his time. He was very colorful.
Just unbelievably captivating.
The most prolific talker.
The greatest world champion of all time.
Willing to do it his way, no matter the consequences.
People are starting to worry about him.
Ric Flair, are you kidding me?
My dad has to slow down.
How in the hell is he doing this?
It was almost like he wanted to die.
I don't know how he survived.
People keep reminding me that I should be dead.
Woo! Okay, now we're back. We just rolled it. So Ric, you know, I think one of the things that I've, you know, grown to love about you, and I feel like you become family, and you know, I remember meeting you a year ago.
Yeah,
you know, like right. You're a sweetheart. And so, you know, what, when you were a kid, like, did you want to be a wrestler? Is that something that you thought about? Like, one day I'm going to be on the WWE. Like, what was that?
No, I always liked it, but I never even thought about it until after I, you know, did so poorly in school. I went to play football in Minnesota and joined a fraternity house and forgot about going to class. So obviously, then they put me in summer school. They wanted me to go for 6 weeks, and I lasted 2 days. I said, I'm out of here. I just got in the car and drove to Chicago, spent the summer with my friend. My parents thought I was still in school for a year.
Oh, my God. Really?
Yeah. Well, there's no cell phones back in the 70s.
Right. But so how did you get connected with wrestling?
One of my good friends was Greg Gagne, who was a year older than me and graduated from Minnetonka or Wayzata High School. And his dad was the wrestling promoter that started me, Vern Gagne, a very famous Olympic wrestler, college collegiate football player, and pro football player.
Yeah.
An Olympian. So, and a great guy, the guy that toughened us all up.
You're a true entertainer, and you really get people excited, right? And, you know, you're known for your, say it,
Woo!
Right? Every time I see you out and I see people coming around, they've got to do it to you, right? Oh, over and over. It never gets old.
Can't wait for the woo choos.
So, like, perfect segue. Let's talk about that, right? Yeah. So, obviously, I'm sure a lot of people have seen the news, right? You know, Ric Flair, you know, you're now part of Tyson 2.0, which is now, you know, the parent company of Karma Holdings, right? So talk to us a little bit about the products and talk to us about, you know, what gets you excited about it, right? You and I obviously have a lot in common as far as utilizing pharmaceuticals to sleep, and now we don't because of cannabis, but we'll get into that in a second. But talk to us about the products out there.
Well, just having the opportunity to meet, Chad Bronstein, who is one of the most inspirational people I've ever met in my life. I have seen a couple times, but he reminds me a lot of Vince McMahon in that he is driven to be the best. And I don't think Chad ever takes I don't think everybody takes a day off. I mean, obviously he relaxes and all that, but and his priority is his family by far, but when he's working and it motivates me. And for him to get me involved in this project, I've never been against cannabis. I just didn't do it.
Right.
Number one, because I had asthma when I was a kid. Number two, it was against the rules and wasn't as socially acceptable as it is now. But I've never had anything against it. And I've certainly been around it my whole life, you can imagine. Everybody smokes dope, which I'm finding out more and more.
Right.
I'm even smoking it more now. just not with Mike.
No, well, you've seen that happen before.
Yeah, you saw that. I know.
You can't punch above Mike's weight when it comes.
Yeah, that's not a pretty sight. Me getting carried back to the room.
Listen. You know what? It's humbling, right? You kind of know your limit. I think I was reading a couple of articles where you were talking about utilizing Xanax for what year was it?
1989.
How many years were you on Xanax?
Was it since 1989? I got off it a couple of times for maybe 6 months or a year at a time, but it's a very difficult withdrawal process, and I ended up saying to myself, it's just easier to just take one. You know what I mean? And I don't abuse it. I just took one a day, at night to sleep. Not during the daytime or anything, and or like I would take one to go to the dentist. I hate the dentist. I don't know why, but
I don't know anybody who likes the dentist. Yeah, come on,
and then it just became convenient, and so when the edibles came along, and someone explained to me that could replace them, it has to be done. Doesn't have to be under the guidance of a doctor, but you have to take. You just don't stop taking Xanax. Just take a quarter, mm-hmm. and you take a third, and then you add a little bit more cannabis, and then and then eventually you don't even notice the difference.
Yeah, no, it's pretty amazing.
Except that it's, I'm sure, a lot medically safer for you with the cannabis, as opposed to being addicted to
So, Ric, when you think back in your career, like all the amazing things you've done, you were this legend, you're still a legend, the entertainer, being up in the ring, having everyone cheer for you. Like, what was your favorite, if you could look back and you're like, that was the best moment of my life?
Well, as far as wrestling, I think, my career, the best part was the 80s for me, the most fun probably. But I'll be honest with you right now that I'm not even, just on the outside looking in, but my daughter is, arguably the greatest of all time, and
amazing wrestler.
To come back, and these documentaries, and working with Chad. I'm actually this stuff, working with Chad now and doing this, is giving me a whole new perspective of life. Where I would just wake up in the morning, work out, go ride my boat, go drink, watch sports. I mean, now this thing is. And it's kept me busy too. This travel with Chad around the country, it's been very motivational for me. And it also, being introduced to some pretty heavyweight people in the industry like yourself, it's a big deal for me. And I'm thankful. I mean, how many people in life get another big run when they're my age? Very few.
I feel like this is the time.
It's amazing. Yeah, but Chad's buying me a big boat. He told me.
He told me that too.
I mean, big boat.
No, he told me.
I mean, 65 feet plus.
I know.
Yeah.
I've been sending him a couple listings. I got you.
For my boat or your boat?
No, I have one, but I've been sending listings for you.
I know. Well, I'm waiting for. I actually thinking he might give it to me for Christmas. So when I see a boat pull out in front of Marriott that won't fit in a slip, I'll know it's mine. It'll be called Ric Flair Drew.
Oh my God, I can't wait to see that. Ric, tell us a little bit about, you know, obviously, you know, we just came from Vegas, yes. And Tyson there, and we had you there. It was a lot of fun.
Diplo, yeah, it was great.
I mean, you were in your element, right? Yeah. You were having a ball.
I have to admit I was.
Yeah. And everybody is literally like, what is going on right now?
Walking around with Mike is a big deal.
Yeah. But I mean, walking around with the both of you too, is just like, you know, it's pretty incredible. And I think too, you know, one of the things that you and Mike are doing a great job on is also destigmatizing the cannabis space. Now, we've come a long way, right? I don't think that we're, you know, 5 years ago was very different from what it is now, but there's still a few people out there that maybe haven't changed their course on cannabis. And you guys are helping do that by publicly going out there, talking to people about the products, talking to ESPN, talking to Fox, CNN, all the networks on how this is helping you. How do you feel like as a person right now after, you know, getting off of Xanax and actually replacing it with cannabis? You probably feel like a different person.
I do. Well, actually, I don't. That's just it. I don't feel a difference. I feel great. The Xanax didn't wear me down. The Xanax didn't wear me down. Like I said, I didn't take it during the day. I couldn't function the way I do normally with the Xanax. It would make me tired, but just to fall asleep at night. But I feel the same. I know it's much healthier, but I feel the same. I don't feel.
All right, that's good. I'm not,
you know, some people. Anytime you change something around that drastically, I think everybody expects you to go through something major. And I haven't experienced that. It's been a real smooth transition for me.
Talk to us a little bit about Ashley.
The queen.
The queen, your daughter.
Yes.
So, you know, she's following her dad's footsteps.
No, she, I'm trying to figure out how to follow her footsteps now. And she's a college graduate with a degree. And I mean, she's been so good at everything that she's ever done. And then she's even better at this. So, would have ever thought, because she didn't even watch it. I mean, she watched me and came to matches, but she was, you know, playing volleyball and cheerleading, gymnastics, and they wanted to play basketball. I mean, I've had athletic directors at high schools get mad at me because I wouldn't make her play basketball. I mean, she just didn't like it. And the pressure was on her, but the parents thought they could, or these coaches thought they could just come to me and say, well, tell Ashley she's going to play basketball. It doesn't work like that with Ashley. And Ashley, do you think you might want to play? No, I don't like it. Yeah. I made her go to a camp one year. And when they asked each one of the kids at the camp in front of all the parents the last day to do something that they learned at the basketball camp, you know what she did?
What?
She walked on her hands from one end of the court to the other.
Really?
Yeah. Whole length of the basketball court.
Wow.
So I learned from basketball dad.
There you go.
In other words, dad, stick it.
So Ric, we have, obviously it's the end of the year is coming up. So this is an amazing year for you. Obviously the brand launch, getting it out there, getting, you know, your products in so many people's hands. Anything that you're really looking forward to for 2023? Anything on the horizon? Obviously, no,
just the continued growth of of the cannabis line. Really behind that, I think we're in 15 states now, and we're trying to be in 24, like Mike.
Yeah.
And then keep pushing that, and just enjoying the work with Chad and with you guys, and looking forward to our next adventure.
I love it.
Yeah.
Listen, I'm looking forward to hanging this winter because it's going to be cold up here. So I'm going to have to come down and, you know, do some.
Yeah. The fraternity house is open.
That's right. I got to get down there. So, but Ric, I appreciate you coming on the show.
Thank you.
You know, you become family and.
Thank you.
You know, I appreciate it.
That means a lot.
I appreciate you.
You guys are my family too. Thank you, Jeff.
All right, buddy.
Woo!